He's coming off a career year out in Colorado. Now he takes his talents to TO, the crazy market around the Toronto Maple Leafs. We'll get into that in just a second. Tyson Barrie joining us here on NHL Tonight, but we're going to start with birthday wishes. Happy belated birthday to you, Tyson. Thanks for doing this.
Yeah, thanks, guys. I'm really milking the birthday. It's been about a week now.
So that's what you got to do. You got to milk it as long as you can. That shirt, I like it, but it looks like something out of the Tyson Nash collection. I got to be honest with you.
Yeah, as long as I don't got the matching nose, then we're good.
Touché, well sir. Touché.
Well, he's in mid-season form time. Yes. Very nice, Tyson. So listen, you finish enjoying your birthday week. Obviously, great celebration. Good for you. Prepping to go to a new team. What's different about that than returning to Colorado where you've been for so long? Now you're going to Toronto. Is there anything different this summer going to a new team?
Yeah, I think changes your mindset a little bit. Just, you know, wrapping your head around a trade. I'd never been traded before. And then, you know, just, you know, you're doing your training as usual, but you're, you know, you got to go. I got to go pack up my stuff and find a place in Toronto and kind of get settled there. So there's lots of moving parts, but it's exciting, and I'm looking forward to joining an awesome team in Toronto.
You mentioned you'd never been traded before. I've been traded a few times, so you get used to it eventually. But what was it like? I mean, apparently you're having dinner with Paul or having lunch with Paul Bissonnette at the time when you got the call. Did you have an inkling that something like this might happen, or were you completely blindsided by it?
I knew my name was out there, and, you know, I'm obviously aware of the situation with my contract. And so I thought it would, you know, it could happen. But to be honest, I wasn't really watching anything. I was just kind of enjoying lunch, and I didn't really think I'd be on the move. And then next thing you know, you're getting a call from Joe Sakic, and it's July 1, so you're thinking, for sure, I'm gone.
Like, what other reason could he be calling me?
As soon as that name pops up on the phone, you know you're gone.
Imagine, though, if he was just calling for something else.
I thought he just wanted to wish me a happy Canada Day.
Well, listen, you're headed to a team with a whole lot of talent, but we all know Toronto is a hockey hotbed, and it takes a certain personality to be able to handle that. Do you fancy yourself someone that doesn't mind the pressure?
No, I think it's a cool experience. I think obviously they're not putting a ton of pressure on you in Colorado, and they like you. You know, they like when you're winning, and you know, when you're not doing so well, it's not the end of the world. So it'll be a cool experience to go in and have, you know, all the pressure and all the expectation, and you know, hopefully deliver on that.
Tyson, what kind of conversations have you had with the Toronto Maple Leafs organization, whether it be Kyle Dubas, Mike Babcock, teammates, about what they are expecting from you when you get to Toronto?
Oh, it's been all positive, all good stuff. I think there's no secret to what my game is, and I think they just want me to bring that there and try to, you know, help them out and you know, get the puck into these forwards' hands and jump in and make plays and create some offense from the back end. But at the same time, you know, I'm gonna have to defend and be relied upon to play against other teams' you know, best players. So it's gonna be an exciting year for me, and I'm looking forward to getting in there and getting it started.
Every time I was traded to a new team, I immediately ran down the roster and said, which one of these guys have I played with before? Who have I crossed paths with, whether junior, internationally? Who on the Leafs do you know who you've played with previously, if anyone?
Yeah, actually, for whatever reason, I know quite a few guys. I know Mitch Marner I played Worlds with, Jake Muzzin, I know JT, I know Morgan Riley because he's from Vancouver. I know Spezza and Anderson, and for whatever reason, I just seem to know a ton of guys on the Leafs, so I'll absolutely take it. They're all great guys, too.
Yeah, it's something nice about walking in a dressing room with some familiar faces.
Oh, I gotta
think
so.
Even if you're experienced like Tyson is, 28 years old, it's still nice to be able to have a smile there available to you.
Well, it's like anything. It's like human nature, right? You walk into a room where you don't know anybody, you're like, all right, who am I making small talk with first?
Even if you're 28 years old.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Well, listen, before we let you go, what do you got on tap the rest of the summer before it's all business again?
You know what? Nothing too much. I've done quite a bit of traveling and stuff, so I'm going to try to hang out in Victoria as much as I can and be there and enjoy some beautiful West Coast weather and just, you know, training and hanging with some friends and family. So nothing too crazy.
By the way, who picked up the bill for lunch that day between you and Biz?
It's not even a question.
Well, definitely not Biz.
Yeah. I'm just saying, I know Austin Matthews was posting recently that Biz picked up the bill. Apparently it's a rare occurrence.
So
I just thought
worthy.
I would.
Yeah. It does happen, I guess.
From time to time. You'll have to ask Austin Matthews what the secret is, maybe.
Yeah, I will.
All right, listen, Tyson, thanks for the time. We appreciate it. Enjoy your time in TO. Best of luck.
Yeah, thanks, guys. Thanks for having me.